up on the bulletin. Let's tell you how it has now completed 1 month of the cash rush. Well, that's right. It's a month today since the Prime Minister announced the ambitious demonetization drive. In fact, opposition parties have unanimously decided to observe today as Black Day, as a mark of completion of a month of the announcement of the scheme. Now, the opposition MPs will be protesting at the Gandhi statue today at 10 a.m., which is roughly an hour from now. The opposition also plans to hold a protest dharna to highlight the miseries that has caused the common man after currency notes of 500 and 1,000 went out of circulation. Well, they will also be tying a black band as a mark of protest outside the parliaments. Both the houses, the opposition will once again press for a discussion along with voting on demonetization. While several measures have been taken by the government post-demonetization, several amendments too have been made, the opposition continues to take the government to task. Well, in fact, a big breaking news that's coming in. We have a reaction coming in from one of the opposition parties. Let's listen in to JDU's Sharat Yadav.
हम यही कह रहे हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री जी ने डिमोनेटाइजेशन किया है. वो जो हालात हैं उनके बारे में, सारी चीजों के बारे में वो ज्यादा कॉम्पिटेंट तरीके से बता सकते हैं. लेकिन मैं सोचता हूं कि अडवाणी जी के कहने के बाद जो एक तरह से विवेक जागेगा.
Well, in fact, let's go across to Payal Mehta, who's joining us from right outside the parliament for more on this. Payal, first of all, give us an idea of what exactly it is that the government, that the opposition parties are planning today to try and corner the government, both inside and outside the house.
Well, of course, today is 1 month ever since Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced that demonetization drive. And of course, that is something which continues to be the most dominating issue both inside as well as outside the parliament. Now, the weather that you see around Meghna is extremely gloomy as well as cold. And that's exactly what the mood is going to be of the opposition towards the government. They will not, in fact, allow the government to have it. So even though the government has been asking for them to come on to debate, they've been trying to reach out to the opposition saying that, you know, let's get together, let's debate on a key issue which concerned the masses. But the opposition has been in a way changing goalposts. First they asked for the discussion. The discussion began in the Rajya Sabha, after which midway they said that the discussion will only continue if the Prime Minister is available in the House and the Prime Minister speaks in the House. Now the Prime Minister came on a number of occasions, but the din continued and the Prime Minister could not in fact address. They had demanded a response of that. Then they demanded that the discussion should be held under Rule 56. Now what Rule 56 also means that this will allow the opposition to censor the government, something which the government did not agree to. Then this often they stand and they said, okay, fine, you know, we're ready to discuss, but there should be voting which should be allowed under Rule 183.84. So that's something which again the government did not allow. The government says that we are ready to give in as many hours as required in terms of demonetization which needed to be discussed. So why not discuss it under Rule 193? So that is exactly where it remains. Now today, being the 8th of December, is exactly a month since that demonetization drive has arrived. And the opposition has been in fact taking pot shots at the government, saying that, you know, the government has only shielded the rich, the mighty and the influential, with several cases coming up, and that the poor man is made to stand at the queues, is made to wait for hours to get it to withdraw their hard-earned money. So this morning at 10 o'clock in the morning, right outside the Gandhi statue, right under the Gandhi statue in fact, the opposition leaders will be holding a protest. They will be in fact putting out placards. They will be in fact shouting out slogans against this government, shouting out slogans against Prime Minister Narendra Modi. This is not it. Right. They are also expected to spot black bands and, you know, both inside as well as outside the parliament. So this is something which is going to continue as an agitation. The opposition had in the past has also been doing this right around the country, whether it is Mamata Banerjee, whether it is the other opposition parties, whether it is the Congress party. So that's going to be what the mood is. Now, very important today, Meghna, Prime Minister Narendra Modi is on roster duty in the Rajya Sabha. He will be sitting in the Rajya Sabha at about 12 o'clock is what we expect him to be in the Rajya Sabha. It is going to be extremely important to see if the opposition at all wants to discuss and will allow him to speak, because, you know, they've been demanding that the Prime Minister should be taking a suo motu notice on his own and start speaking. That is something which is extremely unlikely, because the government says that the Prime Minister is willing to be in the House, is willing to answer.
Well, then, Payal, do stay on with us. Some breaking reactions which is coming in. Let's listen in to Shrikant Sharma.
No नियत ठीक नहीं है विपक्ष की, क्योंकि विपक्ष चर्चा नहीं चाहता, विपक्ष चर्चा से भाग रहा है, क्योंकि जनता को कन्विंस करने के लिए विपक्ष के पास तर्क नहीं है और कुतर्कों के सहारे संसद की कार्यवाही को बाधित करने का प्रयास विपक्ष ने किया है। ये चर्चा के लिए पहले मांग की गई, सरकार पहले दिन से ही चर्चा के लिए तैयार थी, लेकिन विपक्ष अपनी बात तो कहता है फिर हाउस को डिस्टर्ब करता है। कभी अलग अलग तरीके की मांगें आती हैं, प्रधानमंत्री की मांग करते हैं प्रधानमंत्री को सदन में रहना चाहिए, प्रधानमंत्री सदन में है और पहली बार ऐसा हुआ है कि सबसे ज्यादा समय तक रहने वाला प्रधानमंत्री सदन में मोदी जी के रूप में देश को मिला है। उसके बावजूद भी विपक्ष ये नहीं पचा पा रहा है कि नरेंद्र भाई मोदी की लोकप्रियता क्यों बढ़ रही है, क्योंकि हर मोर्चे पर मोदी जी सफल हो रहे हैं, जनता आशीर्वाद दे रही है। भ्रष्टाचार को समूल रूप से नष्ट करना मोदी जी का एक संकल्प है और जनता आज मोदी जी के साथ खड़ी है, लेकिन दुर्भाग्य से जहां विपक्ष को इस मुहिम में सरकार का समर्थन करना चाहिए, लेकिन निजी स्वार्थों के कारण, अपनी राजनीतिक मजबूरियों के कारण, अपने खिसकते जनाधार के कारण विपक्ष चर्चा से भाग रहा है और सरकार को नहीं काम करने दे रहा है। तो हम तो आग्रह करेंगे कि आप कितना पैसा जो टैक्स पेयर का पैसा है,
आई थिंक मिस्टर खरगे हैज डन द राइट थिंग एंड इफ द गवर्नमेंट डज नॉट पे हीड टू इट द मैसेज फर्दर गेट्स कोरोबोरेटेड दैट दिस इज अ गवर्नमेंट बाय फ्यू फॉर फ्यू एंड इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ यू।
In fact, let me go back across to Payal. Payal, of course, it's going to be very relevant today. The Prime Minister is going to be in the Rajya about 12 noon. We are going to be keeping an eye out on that. But talking about the opposition, last time around they held the Akrosh rally. Many would say that perhaps it didn't take off as well as they would have expected. So today, are they likely to take this issue of demonetization out on the streets to the people of the country?
Well, of course, all the opposition parties will be making various attempts to, in fact, reach out to the people at large, even though, you know, there is a symbolic protest in the parliament because the session is on. So obviously, these MPs will try to register their protests right within the premises of the parliament. They cannot be going outside. The Akrosh rally did not really take off, and that is something which the government has taken a lot of heart in, because the government feels that the opposition does not have anything concrete in place. The opposition is just protesting for the heck of it, for just the sake of it, for their own political interest and not for interest, because the one thing that the government is taking a lot of heart from is the fact that surveys, etc., have shown that people have welcomed this move. Understandably, people have faced inconvenience, and that is something which is not being ruled out, and that's probably one of the reasons that over the last few days, or in fact, ever since the demonetization drive was announced, Meghna, the government says that they've been taking various steps. There have been many amendments. There have been many rules that have been changed. There have been options to look at, in fact, trying to see what convenience can be really brought in. But what has been the most most difficult challenge is to ensure that enough liquidity exists in the market. And that is somewhere the government has, in fact, taken a little of a beating, because, you know, obviously, a cash crunch remains to be the key issue. And that is something which the opposition has continued to drive. You know, the fact that about 70 to 80 odd people have lost their lives standing in queues, etc., who is responsible for that? The opposition leaders, in fact, if you remember, then Ghulam Nabi Azad in the past had gone ahead and, infamously, you know, sort of compared that that series of deaths to what we had seen during a terror attack. So that is the kind of emotion that is running in there. The opposition is not going to relent as far as anything is concerned. Very importantly, Meghna, no bills have been passed. You know, you've been into parliament for about 21 days odd. For now, there have been no bills which have been passed in this session at all. It continues to be nearly a washout. Now, with Saturday, Sunday coming your way, Friday is obviously a private members' bill day, so hardly any business expected. Saturday,
absolutely.
Sunday
it's
is,
unfortunate,
you know,
of course, that the taxpayers' money is going down the drain, but it doesn't see that even today we expect any kind of actual legislation to happen in the parliament. It's likely to be another day of protest. Well, keep tracking the developments there, Payal. Thank you so much for getting us those inputs. Of course, Parliament is where all the action is going to be later on in the day. We'll keep dipping back, getting you more inputs, live inputs on this. But for the time being, some of the reactions also which have been coming in.
Well, it is Prime Minister Modi who has been bunking the parliamentary session. It is his party that is refusing to discuss demonetization under a rule in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha which will entail voting. And so, therefore, here we find that the Prime Minister is the absconder. So, he is the one who is undermining parliamentary democracy.
नोटबंदी का पूरा असर दिखाई दिया. मोदी जी चाहते थे कि पूरा देश ठप हो जाए, औद्योगिक उत्पादन ठप हो जाए, जो मजदूरों को काम मिला है वो ठप हो जाए और पूरी तरह से वो कारगर साबित हुआ। लेकिन सवाल ये है कि नोटबंदी की वजह से जितने लोगों की मौत हुई है और जितने लोग लाइन में आज भी खड़े दिखाई दे रहे हैं उनकी संख्या करोड़ों में है।